Hi, I'm Ryan Sufian, and I would say I sing, a little bit of acting also. Okay, actually, I would say I'm a late bloomer. Okay, because it started out as a hobby, you know, like influenced by the TV shows like Singapore Idol, American Idol, and then you know you just wanna pretend to sing in front of the audience kind of stuff. Masih ku merasa angku terbang kenanganku jauh langit kan menangkapku walau kan terjatuh dan bila semua tercipta hanya untukku merasakan semua yang tercipta hampa hidup terasa. Tetap ku mencari arti untuk ku membagi menemani langkahku namun tak berarti dan bila semua tercipta tanpa harus ku merasakan cinta yang tersisa hampa hidup terasa bagai bintang di surga dan seluruh warna dan kasih yang setia dan cahaya nyata. Oh bintang di surga berikan cerita dan kasih yang setia dan cahaya nyata. Tetap ku mencari arti untuk ku membagi menemani langkahku namun tak berarti dan bila semua tercipta tanpa harus ku merasakan cinta yang tersisa tanpa hidup terasa bagai bintang di surga dan seluruh warna dan kasih yang setia dan cahaya nyata. Oh bintang di surga berikan cerita dan kasih yang setia dan cahaya nyata. But then started like, you know, bathroom singing, and then I joined small competitions like all those organized by the schools. And okay, because when I started singing like an original song, which means you have to go to a recording studio, and then that is where your vocals can be heard clearly. Where if you go like pitchy, you go off key, out of tune. You can hear very clearly lah. So that is where my producer Yazri told me that, hey, are you tone deaf or what? Why are you always speechy? So I believe for a couple of years I thought I am tone deaf. But then before all this, I singing at night with my acoustic band regularly, and I don't really go off pitch. I think it's more like your ears are not trained. So I'm not used to recording in a studio. So, but I would say now I can say that I am able to do less mistakes when I go to the recording studio and record my original song. Yeah.
Whenever I'm weary from the battles that rage in my head, you make sense of madness when my sanity ends by you.
Ramadan, because COVID and pre-COVID is totally two different things. I love the kecohness of Ramadan because that's where like you get to eat together. It's not that we don't eat together before Ramadan. It's just that more meaningful as a family because you get to fasting and buka puasa. But then COVID times, it's actually I would say not that good or very good lah. It's just that. Much more closer as a family because we stay at home. We try not to mingle outside with friends and other companies. So we are closer as a family because we eat together. We stay in the house together. We don't have a choice. We have to stay at home. And we do all kinds of things at home. Occupy ourselves as a family, like play games or watch videos, meaningful videos, and do our rituals, prayers and everything. Yeah, so that's more meaningful for me, Ramadan, this time now. Actually, as a family tradition, of course, you have to visit your grandmother, your grandfather, your mother, your father in you know, at their houses, right? So that's a must before, pre-COVID. But then now since COVID, so we can't really go to the go visiting. I would call it go visiting. I mean, it's in a good way that we don't have to rush ourselves to visit. We take time, and then at one time when we visit our family, it's just our family and our parents, not cousins and relatives. So much more interaction, you know, more tighter the what do you call it, the visiting. I would say, yeah. You know what? Because actually, when I grow older, then I start to appreciate Kampong Glam. Because before this, I don't really hang out at Kampong Glam. Because over here, there's a lot of food, restaurants, but not a lot of, what do you call it? Chill places. Chill places. So, when I have my family, we quite often go to Kampong Glam because, I don't know, maybe because I got married over here. I got married at Mamanda. I was solemnized there. So definitely it means a lot to me.
Menjelang hari raya, berakhirnya puasa, bergema takbir senja, menyambut Syawal tiba. Suasana riang riang terlihat sini sana.
Hingga kini